Theory Cube Science Hour. I'm your host, Betty Quimby. Today we'll be talking about rates of reactions in stoichiometry. With us is our very own Dr. DeBrickshaw Romeo Jackson. Our special guest for the day is Dr. Jasmine Tate, who specializes in rates of reactions in stoichiometry. Doctor?
Hello, my name is DeBrickshaw Romeo Jackson. Today we will be talking about chemistry on Gary Cubed. Today we will be learning about reaction rates and stoichiometry. Having a basic understanding of reaction rates can be very useful in our lives. For example, drug design, pollution control, and food processing are some of the many examples where understanding reaction rates are essential. Any general reaction can be represented by this chemical equation. See here, reactants form products. This shows that during the course of a reaction, reactants are consumed while products are formed. As a result, we can monitor the progress at a reaction by observing either the decrease or increase of concentration of the products. The easiest way to find a rate of reaction is by using this simple equation. Rate equals negative delta A over delta T.
Wait a minute, why is that equation negative?
It is negative because the reactants are lost to form products. A is the change in concentration. However, delta T is the change in time period. You can measure the rate of appearance of the products by removing the negative sign because products are being formed.
Now Dr. Jasmine Tate will explain a little bit further.
If you were to graph the rate equation, this is what it would look like. Let's start off by taking a look at the axes of the graph. If you look at the x-axis, you can see the unit is in time per second. On the y-axis, you can see it is labeled in number of moles. The black dotted line are the reactants, and the red dotted line is the products. The rate of reaction from A to B represented as the decrease of A molecules with the time and as the increase of B molecules with time. Because over time, as the product increases, reactant decreases.
Dr. DeBrickshaw, do you think you could tell us more about average rates?
Sure, Betty. The average rate is the rate of a reaction over a certain period of time. Here's the equation for average rate. You see here is negative A sub F minus A sub I over T sub F minus T sub I, which means the final concentration minus the initial concentration divided by the final time minus the initial time.
Oh, I see. Thank you. Now, what about instantaneous rates? Do you know anything about that, Dr. Jasmine?
By calculating the average reaction rate over shorter and shorter intervals, we can obtain the rate for a specific instant of time, which will give us the instantaneous rate for that time. Here's the equation for average rate. It relates to instantaneous rate because the time intervals, if you push them closer and closer together, you'll be able to calculate the instantaneous rate for that reaction at a certain time.
You can find the rate of an instant in time by drawing a tangent to that point on the graph. If you want to find the rate at time equals 100 seconds, you would draw a tangent to the point x equals 100. If you then find the slope of the tangent, which is rise over run, you will find the rate of at this instant.
So Dr. Jasmine, what do you know about rate constants?
The rate constant is a constant of proportionality between the reaction rate and the constant of the reactant. Wait, I need an equation. I know there's an equation around here somewhere.
Betty, do you mean this equation?
I do. Thank you so much. As you can see here, rate is directly proportional to the reactant A, which means rate equals K times A. If you rearrange this equation, we can solve for K. So K equals rate over reactant.
You win the purple.
I'm a little confused. Can you give me an example?
No.
2 moles of A disappear for every mole of B that forms. That is, the rate of disappearance of A is twice as fast as the rate of appearance of B.
Boy, you know me well, said I'm that kind of feeling.
And thank you for watching Dairy Cube Science Hour.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment that you captured.